hopefully we'll be back here in first place.
Transmission oil!
Mira.
Mira. Bueno.
That's our day. All right, we made it. Race day for the 2022 San Felipe 250. New engine, new transmission package, new steering package, new brake package, new Fox live valve suspension package. We threw a lot at this thing, hoping it would pay off, and you'll see. All right, so here we are, start line of the 2022 San Felipe 250. Right here on the infamous Malecon. Got the start line right up there. And yeah, feeling really good about today. Feeling confident, truck's 100%. Got some stiff competition starting in front of us. Got my cousin Dan behind us, Luke in front of us. So it should be a fun day. We're looking forward to it. Gonna do a little bit different strategy today than what I've been doing the last couple races, and try and just stay patient, stay calm, and let the race come to me in the later miles. So yeah, we're ready, ready as can be. Excited for the day. Got my whole family down here supporting me for the first time in a couple years. Yeah, so we're excited to get the race underway. Hopefully we'll be back here in first place, if not physically, then on corrected time. So let's do it. Johnny, hold on. Johnny, how are we doing today?
I'm doing pretty excellent.
How's the
race day is finally here.
How's the butterflies in the belly doing?
Butterflies in the bellies are non-existent.
Really?
No, I'm feeling game day, ready to race, ready to fight, ready to go fast,
game day.
To tear these guys up.
Okay, you guys heard it here first from the man, the myth, the legend, Sir Johnny Nelson. No butterflies. I'm not gonna lie, I got some butterflies, but they're calm butterflies, and yeah, we're ready to go win this thing. So. Let's go do it.
And we are here in beautiful San Felipe, back on the Malecon for the 35th running Score San Felipe 250. Very excited to be down here. We have number 31. This is the Red Bull Toyo Tires truck of Andy McMillin.
Down there, huh? Brother.
Oh, is that eight? It's done?
Yeah, that's why you couldn't go.
Well, you had a quick pit.
You did? It was less than 30 seconds. I know you had a great pit.
I know.
Luke had a 10-second pit over there.
Yeah, I didn't know what to think when the transmission let go. Sorry, the torque converter let go inside the transmission. It was obviously disappointing, but my whole family was there, which I was really excited about, and I was happy to see them. Unfortunately, my son had like the beginnings of an ear infection, so he's like crying and screaming bloody murder off in the corner. So like, it went from like, oh, the race is done and like that's a bummer, to like, I want to make sure that my family's okay and my son's feeling good. So honestly, that's the most important thing. You know, racing is racing, and we all want to win and we all want to be successful. But at the end of the day, it's all about family, and it's all about your health. And And those are the two most important things you have in life. So everyone was good. My cousin won the race, and we all stay in the same compound. So we got to, you know, kind of celebrate his win with him and his team and eat some tacos and drive home Sunday and start preparing for war on Monday. Could be at the finish line. Had a lot of downtime today, unfortunately. We're running pretty good. I don't know. We were down quite a bit at the beginning. Had a fluke thing, lost both of our spare tires. Our strap broke that holds those down. It's about mile 50. We had to pull over and get a new strap out and rack a couple of tires, and that took us a couple of minutes, and about three or four trucks went by. Then we just kind of kept charging, picked off some trucks one by one. We were back forth on the road where we started. And the guys up front were stretching out, and then I would reel them in, and they'd stretch them out, and then I'd reel them in. And then coming into our main pit at mile 1 to 68, about 20 miles out, we started losing a converter. Converter started getting hot in the transmission. And we just nursed it into the pit. Figured everything was still okay because we were still running. We were just going to nurse it all the way back around. And we went to leave the pit, and it was all neutrals. And we didn't have any forward motion. So we decided to change the transmission and get a finish out of it, because how we finish here is how we start the Baja 500. So finishing was highly important. And making it to the finish line and just celebrating that success, you know, like something kind of out of our control took us out of the race. Other than that, all the late nights the guys were putting in at the shop, you know, they all paid off to a certain extent, and that there was zero issues with the truck. Besides that, zero issues with the pit equipment, with all the chase vehicles. And, you know, it's Baja. And, you know, you just got to persevere and grit your teeth and try and make it through better next time. All right, so this wraps up the 2022 San Felipe 250 with our four-part YouTube episode series. Let us know what you guys think. Do you guys want more for the Baja 500? Would you rather see different things? Do you want more in-depth stuff at the shop? Let us know in the comments. We're here for you guys, and we want to put out good content that's inspiring and that's captivating and motivating. And, you know, honestly, just exactly what's going on. And we're not going to sugarcoat anything. And this is how we are. This is how I am. This is who I am. This is my team. This is my guys. And now on to conquer the Baja 500. So we will be doing another series for the Baja 500, similar format, a lot different views as the course is gonna go over a lot different terrain rather than just out in the open desert. So some really pretty scenery, should be really fun, so stay tuned.